What's up, everybody? It's J Chaos. I'm going to be talking about the current state of play with multiverses. So let's get into it. All right. So I'm gonna just hop straight into it because I'm trying to make this short. I already made two videos on my Twitch, so I'm gonna try to make one for the YouTube that'll be short. So let's try to do it. So first things first is. State of play for this game still not really changed that much. They've made a lot of changes and it's not been a good look. If you ask me, I believe that they are making too many changes way too quickly. So it's like you can get adjusted to something on a character, or even yourself offensively, you can get adjusted to something on a character. But mostly it's defensively you're trying to adjust to a character, because these characters are constantly being changed offensively, never really defensively. So all of the changes that are being made are either helping out the offensive player, or that's it. Literally just helping out the offensive player. So this game is very inconsistent, and that's a very bad thing to have for a game. So let me just kind of say the two things that are mainly wrong with this game. Now, I do believe that there are some balancing changes that need to happen. However, they're not really, like, a lot. If you didn't watch my new tier list, it's a tier list that will make a lot of people happy, but it's not, like, my true, like, idea of what I think the characters are, just because I believe a lot of people just don't believe it just yet. But that is a very accurate tier list, in my opinion, of what this game is. Also, that A that I put should be A+. So if you haven't watched the video, if you have some time, go watch that. It's cool. It's my current view on the best characters in the game. However, let's talk about the current state of play after, you know, all of the changes. So one thing that is good about this game is that the developers are very active. They love to talk and communicate with their player base, which is cool. And they are trying, you know, that's awesome. However, let's talk about this game. And let's be brutally honest about it. Number one, you can get in my comment section and type whatever you want. I really don't care. There's nothing you can do. You can't hurt me. I can't hurt you. I don't really care what you say. If you have something constructive to say, then I care. But if you're going to be like a little butthole, then go be a butthole. I literally just delete your comment. I lie. I'm not a person who censors. I'll leave it there. So I really don't care what people are going to say, but I'm just being brutally honest. First thing I'm going to say is state of play of this game is it's extremely noob fest. There's no such thing as pro play in this game right now. The definition of a pro is someone who is getting paid to play. And so there are pros, but the highest level of play is nothing like what I would consider pro play to look like. And that's not a knock on the highest level of play that we're currently seeing out of the best players in this game currently, because I don't look at pro players like it's a person. I look at it like it's an idea, it's a work ethic, it's a level of consistency out of a person that is showing the idea of pro play. And right now, from what I've seen from LTC and everything that I've seen just from formations and how in-depth this game is, there's like a hard plateau in this game right now. It's like a canyon, right? There's this plateau that players have not been able to break through. And until we break through that plateau as a community or as the highest level of players, there's no such thing as pro play in this game. Because watching LTC, and on top of watching LTC, looking at all the changes that they made and how big of a difference it made, because the characters really that got buffed really were never like even that. They just buffed them to where people would use them, and all of a sudden you have all these random characters. I don't know, man. Like, this game is an absolute colossal joke, but it's still a fun game. However, right now this game is in a position where there's a hard plateau that players cannot get past, and it's not their fault. So again, I'm not saying this to spite any pro player who is by definition a pro player, someone who's getting paid to play. I'm not downing any of you guys who went to tournaments, who participated, whatever. I'm not downing any of the influencers who are really good, whatever. I'm just speaking facts. There's no such thing as pro play in this game. Why? Because Pro Play looks way better than everything that I've seen from this game, even out of myself. I can't say that I'm pro. I think everyone in this game right now is really mid, even the best players. And that's not to say that there isn't a skill gap, because there really is, and it's a large skill gap because movement is the meta currently. But there's such another level of potential that I've just found in the lab. I haven't been able to recreate because I don't really think this game is worth it because of everything that I'm seeing, and LTC really proves that to me, that this game is a joke. Even though it's an open beta, and I get that they're trying to hype the game up and all that, but this game has two very big issues that need to get fixed immediately for this game to be taken seriously. And not only that, for the highest level of play that we currently have and the best players that we have to actually be able to get closer to what pro play looks like. Because right now, what we're seeing is not good. If you watch this game and compare it to other platform fighters, this is my first platform fighter, so I had a lot of high expectations comparing it to other fighting games that are much more polished. So you can blame me for having high expectations, but at the end of the day, it's a fighting game. If you fight, you're expected to win. You're expected to have a way to win. Everything is winnable in my eyes, and there are just methods that you have to take in order to do that. And as a developer, your job is to make it to where it's accessible for people to do those things, and that's just not the case. So again, even though I believe that there's a lot of like bad play that's going on, even in the highest level of play, certain things I'm just like, what? Like, if you've ever slowed down this game to 0.0, I mean 0.25, and you watch LTC all of the fights like I've done, you will sit there and be like, what am I watching? This game, it's like this game is so much of a joke that even the highest players, it's like they're not even like taking it that seriously. It's like they're just doing the things that are like kind of obvious that you are supposed to have if you're a high level player, which is teamwork, map positioning, linking, movement, stuff like that, right? That's all that you're really seeing. Defensively, this game has no, like, the only thing that I'm seeing that's impressive in this game is offense. Now, any game that's all offense and no defense, it's never going to be a good meta. That game is actually a joke, right? Defense wins championships. Defense makes a player a pro. Offense doesn't make you a pro. You have to be able to play defense, right? You have to be able to have options to like tech stuff like that. Now, I'm not talking about every sport. But for most sports, you have to have some sort of defense, because you can't just be an offensive player and be able to, like, if you only played offense on in basketball, you will probably be a bench player, right? Technically, you even if you can't play defense, you still have to play defense, which means you could be like the greatest scorer ever, but if you're a liability on defense in basketball, you're out of there. You can be the greatest puncher ever, but if you have trash defense, you're probably gonna be able to like get knocked out really easily. For example, you look at somebody like Wilder, you know, Tyson Fury dominated that guy. And I was a fan of both. So you have to have defense. But this game makes that very hard. So until defense is something that's able to be done consistently, and there's ways for people to do that. For example, I know option selects and stuff and 75-25s, 100-0s that I have found that no one is using. And it's not because they can't use it. It's like, even if they did know how to use it, how do you actually master that to where you don't have to think about it? Because if you have to think, you're already too slow. If you ever heard of a thing, it's called Wuxian mode. No one's in Wuxian mode in this game. No one. I've only seen a few players actually get into that mode. And I'm not going to say their names because I don't want to call people out. I don't want to say and speak on certain things because that's not important. I'm not trying to start beef or nothing like that. But there's only a very few set of players that are actually pro play in this game, in my opinion. One of them I can say, and that's TK. Shaggy T. Or however people call Tamu no Kuniro, however you say it. Yeah, TK. He's a very, very good player in ones. Now, I haven't seen him too much in twos because twos requires two teammates. I don't think he has a teammate that has really meshed with him yet, but he's a very good player. I love watching him play because he simulates pro play the best, in my opinion, because what he's able to do is so much better than what I've seen other players be able to do. But in all honesty, this is not a ones game, it's a twos game. So twos wise, I really can't find a player that I really am like, this player is like bomb. You know what I'm saying? Or this team is like bomb, right? I literally watch any team and every team get mollywopped by average players. You hop on their stream, I get not everyone every time they're trying or whatever, but the point should still stand that pro play, you're supposed to have an answer because a pro player can beat the most OP and broken character and dominate against that player in like if for example if an average player is using the most OP character, a OP player, a pro player should be able to use this character and beat that character easily because that player who's using the most OP character is not the best player, right? Pro play brings a certain level of like a pro. So let me explain what a pro is and then I'll explain the two things that's wrong with this game and then I'll be the end of this video. A pro player to me is someone who has an answer for everything. Someone who has developed tech, option select, defense, offensive strategies, play styles, matchup knowledge, whatever it may be, team comp, positioning, whatever it may be in any sort of fighting game or any sort of competitive game. It doesn't even have to be fighting, it can be a sport, whatever. To beat whatever they have thrown and also the ability to adapt. I do believe in order to be a pro in this game, you cannot play just one character because of how easy it is to counter in this game. Especially with certain characters now getting a little bit more shine, just because the developers overtune the heck out of them, just so people will start playing and not just playing the easier characters to use that skill pad. But you can't play just one character. And it's like that for a lot of games. If you're a one trick, sure, you can be very good and beat a lot of characters and you have to work hard against other matchups, but it's possible. This is pro play. You can beat your counter just by you being that much better and outplaying. That's the way that it is. A pro finds a way to win no matter what it is. Or they use the best characters to beat the best characters. Or they use the best character to beat the regular like characters. And use the best character to beat the average players or even the pro players. That's just how pro play is. You do what you can to win, right? Currently, right now, there really isn't that in this game, and it's not their fault. So, to me, a pro has a certain level of work ethic, a certain level of labbing experience, a certain level of matchup knowledge that just completely, whenever people watch them play, you're like, I didn't even know you can do that. If you cannot watch somebody play and be like, I didn't even know that they could do that. I didn't even know that's a way to counter. I didn't even know that was a way to option select. I didn't even. If you cannot watch somebody play and see and they inspire you to know and you see a level of experience and knowledge in the game that other players just do not have or something that's hard to execute, that is not pro play in my eyes. I have not seen anything in LTC that I'm like, I can't do that. That's way too. Like. And you could be like, okay, well, it's just a game. No. Every single game that I have ever played has had that level of like, and you know what that means to me? That means that this game is just not seeing pro level play yet. And it's not their fault. So what are the two things that is the biggest problem with this game? And this is where the main thing is. So the biggest problem with this game is number one, and I'm gonna showcase it, is the lab. If let's talk about a character who got a huge nerf. So, Superman, for example, a lot of people have been complaining about this character forever and ever and ever and ever and ever. What have they been complaining about? Complaining about his armor, complaining about his fear and his nair, and even complaining about his grab, right? And his up smash. So, if you wanted to lab against his grab, please tell me how would you do so? Somebody tell me how you can make a Superman bot, right? So, let's say out of all these things you see here, please tell me it's an up special, right? This is what he does. All of his aerial moves are non-existent in this game. In the lab, let's say try jump. There's no other option. So the only way for you to technically do it is to put him on very hard, and then jump, and then work on it like that, and then wait, and then wait. Somebody please tell me how this is an effective way to consistently build muscle memory against a move's timing. And then this is offline. So there's no online latency. And there's no setting that you can see in here that can simulate online latency while you're offline so that way you can have the same timing that's more consistent to what you would feel in online latency. So please tell me how any player who is complaining about Superman's grab is able to actually get into the lap and counter that move that is bullying them. That is a bully tactic move that is really hard to lab against. The only way for you to do so is to go into a custom games with a teammate, which number one, that's already way too much to ask out of a player because you would have to first find a teammate and then actually find one that was actually willing to lab to get that to happen. So, how do you lab against Grap? Somebody please tell me how do you lab against Fair into Nair? Somebody please show me how. Somebody please tell me how do you practice actually doing off ledge like play by yourself? Because you can put this bot on very hard and this bot will not follow you down here. See what I'm saying? Somebody please tell me how do you work on the core mechanics of this game without actually having to hop online or find a friend? That's two things that just really make it really, really hard because number one, online there's so much more stuff that's going on. You have match of knowledge. You have to be able to work on these basic things. The average player doesn't have even the basic mechanics of this game mastered. Why? Because you can't really even focus on the basic mechanics because there's so much fast crap going on in the game, and on top of all of that fast crap going on, you have these characters that just like throw so many things at you, and then you have to do all of that with the stress of actually playing with the character that you also have to get better at. You know, there's so much stuff going on. Hopping online to get better is not a good way to get better. Everyone knows this. If you're a pro, you cannot hop online to get better. You have to either scrim against a very good player or lab in the lab. That's the best ways to get better. So there's no way for you to lab against Superman and his stuff that's actually oppressive. So what the developers do, they nerf Superman's grab. So now you have this grab, all of these frames of whiff recovery. That's ridiculous, right? Whenever it could have been easy, which is you program these bots to where you, let's say there's a little tab here and it says record AI. So whenever you hit that button, let's say it's this one, right? You hit that and you hit resume training, it opens up this menu. And if you press the start button or you press whatever button, then you can like do this into this, right? And then all of a sudden now you actually do that combo, right? And then you end the recording and it resets. And then now that bot who's right here does that exact same group of inputs. And then you could place yourself here at the beginning, let's say you can place yourself whatever, and now you can actually work against that certain linkage or that certain mix-up because that's not a true combo always. It's actually not always true. So being able to know when to dodge, right? Can I dodge to the side? Can I dodge back and punish? Can I dodge down and punish? Can I do like this and then punish like that, right? Can I do like movement? Working on every bit of options that you have, right? Or can I push a button in between this and actually beat him? Right? Or am I always going to get hit no matter what he does? And if I do this move and I do this, if he did another move instead of him doing his Nair, is this going to beat that option still? There's no way for you to do that in the lab in this game. No way whatsoever. And if there was a way, it's not consistent. So that makes pro play almost non-existent in this game because you cannot build option selects effectively. And there are option selects in this game. That's why I say there's a huge plateau in this game. But no one's able to do it because the lab sucks. You can't even stack perks in this game, in the lab. So you can't work on any of the things that make a character strong, right? So is that the community's fault for complaining against a nerf? No. How would they be able to do so except hopping online and be like, oh, it's easy, just dodge. Guess what? The servers are laggy. It's not as easy as just dodge, right? Even though the move is very, very telegraphed and you can easily dodge it, right? But sometimes you have to deal with lag, and that's a problem. So sometimes you have to dodge things on prediction timing. That's just the way that things go. If you can't sit there and do that, or lab these moves, or lab certain mix-ups that players do, players will not be able to have an answer for it. They will not know when to dodge against these things. So now, technically, the only way to actually like lab against Superman is actually to play Superman yourself and to sit there and be like, okay, when does this bot like dodge out of this? This is the only way to actually know when to like do your dodge timing. It's like, when is this bot able to dodge out? Right? So we know that this is all consistent, right? And like you'll be able to know if they dodge, you can dodge bonus. That's the only way to actually lab against the characters by actually playing the character yourself. This is just not a good healthy meta. And that's not good for the game. So the state of play of this game is absolutely horrible because the lab sucks. Take another character, for example. Let's say you struggle against Cannonball. Please tell me, how do you lab against Cannonball? Now, this is actually a unique one, since he can actually do Cannonball from the ground. So that's the only way that's possible. So this is why I say, like, people shouldn't be complaining about him, because you can actually, like, sit there and do this stuff on reaction, be like, oh shoot, and you can actually work on this, right? So if you struggle against Cannonball, this is actually one of the moves that you can actually work on. It's like, okay, that move doesn't work, right? Like, okay, that move doesn't work. And then you also are actively learning the hitbox for this move and the timing, so you can actually lap against Cannonball. So Cannonball is not one of those. So for example, Taz Tornado, that's another one, right? Only characters who have, like, a move, their best move that is on, like, neutral, for example, Shaggy's, for example. So, like, let's say you take Shaggy and you have his side special. This is one of those moves that, I don't know why he's going that way, but that's a character where you can actually lab his side special. Why? Because it's something that's on the ground. But if you have a character who's aerially dominant, how do you practice against that? How do you know when you can punish? How do you know when to dodge, right? Like, a lot of people don't know that it's actually better to just neutral dodge and then punish. But how are they supposed to lab these things whenever you can't even get these bots to do aerial combat consistently over and over again, until you can master that timing and, like, get them to, like, let's say, for example, you act as a Shaggy and you, like, you make them do this, this, and then dodge out, right? So that way you, like, do the move and then you dodge out. So now you have to find a way to either whiff punish that move to space it properly to where you can, like, make them whiff to where you can punish it, or dodge it and then see if you can punish it like this, and see if it's possible to punish like that. Or if not, then dodge the move and then, like, try to punish it again, right? So, like, to see if you can punish their dodge attempt. But there's no way for you to do that in the game. You just kind of have to think about it and hope that it happens. There's no way to build that muscle memory. And again, if you have to think about it, it's going to be too slow. It's not going to be good, which is the reason why the meta in this game is so new, so trash. It's like, what are you watching? This game is really hard to look at, especially in twos. It's like, bro, what is this? And ones is really just people just spamming, like, safety. Like, they throw a move that's really safe and they dodge out. Throw a move that's safe and they dodge out. And how do you beat it? Because once you really look at this game from its core, that's the biggest problem. If you ever watch a 1v1 tournament, it's literally, like, it's like, bro, what is this? Is this really what this game is in, like, a 1v1 format? 2 saves this game because it kind of makes it to where you can kind of just double up or blitz people, which is the reason why that's the current meta for this game, is blitzing. So there's really no way for you to, like, let's say, for example, a character like LeBron, 3/4 of his moveset is in the air. 3/4. None of that you can access in the lab. How do you lab against LeBron? That's the reason why LeBron actually has a higher win ratio. He destroys noobs. Why? How do you lab against him, right? How do you get Finn to throw his gym in the lab? So that way you can lab it to work on even the animation, reaction time, getting that, because you can't do any of that stuff, right? So that's the biggest problem with this game right now, is, and that's the reason why a lot of players are complaining, and it's justified. It's not because they're bad players. Well, technically, pro still finds a way. So I consider everyone in this game mid, and every one of us bad, because we're just not at that level of play. None of us, even the highest level of players, we're not at that level yet. But it is what it is. It's not really our fault. The lab sucks. And until you have a door, you'll never be able to get through that plateau. Right now, the lab is closed. The door is closed. So that true level of pro play is not accessible. So what's the other issue? I said it already, the servers. Once you get the servers intact, then even being able to hop online to actually get better consistently timing these things whenever you finally do go against this one character will be good. The biggest problem is, let's say you struggle against the Garnet matchup. Please tell me, how are you going to get better at that matchup? Are you going to go against Garnet bot on the hardest difficulty? Guess what? That bot is still stupid easy. You're not learning anything. And what if you're going against a character or a player who is really, really good with Garnet, who doesn't do anything that the bot is doing, who's spamming a missile that you've never seen before? Please tell me, how do you beat that? Please tell me, how do you lab against that? Please tell me how you get better at this matchup. Do you find a really good Garnet? And then, like, please tell me, how do you find a good Garnet? What does that mean? What, you send them an invite on the socials? You can't send them a message. You just invite them to the lab, they're just gonna fight. What if you want to practice against a certain move? There's no team comms. This game has no team chat, no team communication, nothing. How do you even learn? How do you get better at this game? Somebody please tell me. And I say this as a person who, used to be top 5K here and then top 7K here, right? And I just stopped playing this game because of this. Because if I want to get better at a matchup, I can't do it against a bot because they don't do the things that I need them to do. And if I fight a for one time, I actually find a good player, I'm like, dang, I have to add this person. And then it's like, what if they don't want to be at it? How do you actually learn this matchup? You have to play the character yourself. And still you don't actually know exactly because everything is different in online in latency. So I do apologize. So this game is a joke right now. And this is just one format, right? Let's say again you are trying to work on some sort of like team comp, right? And you're trying to please tell me how do you work against certain things? That's the reason why certain people are like, bro, this team comp's busted, that team comp's busted. And I get it, the game is new, so it just came out. So people are gonna be like, oh bro, this is busted, that's busted, that's busted. Because it's easier to do that because number one, you can't even begin to even fathom how to even practice against that because it's not possible in the lab. There's no recording, there's no nothing like that. It just even having the option to actually do so would have been nice. Even if it was tedious, like let's say you can't even invite your teammate to the lab. That is one of the biggest L's that this game is taking right now. You cannot invite your own teammate to the lab. That's the reason why a lot of pro players cannot do team linking to the level that it needs to be in order for me to even be impressed. Because I'm like, all I need to do is like, I literally trained up one of my friends. I'm like, this is what I need you to do. And in one day, he was able to link exactly how I've seen like some pros do. The highest level of like play that I've seen link wise is Sinewman and Leviathan. Their linking is god tier. They're the closest thing that I will see to pro play linking in teamwork. How do they even get the practice? I don't even know. Either they're, I don't even know. Like, I really don't know. But whatever they're doing, they're good. But you, they're probably going into custom games. But I don't want a bot to move. I don't want to like worry about the bots. I'm trying to get me and my teammate right. And if I am wanting to, I want to have control over it so I can control the scenario and create a situation, so that way I can control that. So that way I can make it a consistent form of practice because randomly practicing does not make you a better player, right? Practice doesn't make perfect. Practice makes permanent. You can practice something in the lab that has nothing to do with the game whatsoever, and it's not making you a better player. It's making you permanently do something that has no in-game like relevance. So I know that because I've learned this in other fighting games or other games where I went pro. You have to practice perfectly so it can be permanently perfect. You can't just be practicing random crap, which is exactly what the lab is. You're just practicing random crap that has nothing to do with how this game meta has or the gameplay has been evolving. Nothing that you do in these labs is going to make a difference. It's really just for you to do against a bot that's standing there and learning whenever like people can dodge. That's it. There's nothing for you to do defensively in here that really makes you better. Really makes you better. Some people might disagree, that's on them, but I'm looking at this from the like the highest level of play that's going to be possible. This lab is absolutely an atrocity. So I believe that right now the biggest things that are holding this game back is team comms, team chat, the ability to send messages to people. I don't care if it's censorship. Bro, people are gonna do whatever they want to do anyway. That's not really like something that you gotta worry about. Put a profanity filter, whatever, and then allow people to text. Just, I don't care if they talk to whatever. I don't care. Allow people to text because you need to be able to make friends or do whatever to where you can build. Because you need team chemistry in this game to even like a lot of pro players or a lot of like high level players are only high level because they have a teammate that's actually really good at the game as well, who they've been working with their chemistry together. A lot of players have not been able to even touch anything close to what this game is going to be like because a lot of players are leaving and you have to build team chemistry in order to even be considered a good player in 2v2s. Right? So there needs to be some sort of team chat. There needs to be some sort of, team voice so that way you can talk to a player, you can develop chemistry, synergize with that person. Literally, when you click this junk right here. I know this is getting a little bit longer than I want it to be. I do apologize, but kind of I've always been like this. pick characters that synergize and use co-op abilities to best your opponents. How do you even know what synergizes? If you can't even talk to your teammate, you have to pick your character before you even find your teammate. Right? And you can't switch it. It's like, please tell me how any of this makes sense. This game, it's like, sure, it's cool, but they didn't really think anything of this out. And it's like a joke. So, I don't know. They need to, number one, make it to where you find your teammate before you pick your character. And be like, hey, yo, who do you play? Or whatever. And I get it. People be like, oh, bro, I don't want to play with that character. Whatever. It could be like that. Oh, well, make them leave a game or whatever. You don't even got to answer the question. You can literally just hop on and don't say nothing until you pick your character, and then it is what it is. But you need to be able to build around your teammate. And that's the reason why a lot of people are just one-tricking, because it's like, why would I play another character? I don't even know what the other characters are playing. You can't build around until you already lost or won, right? It's kind of trash. Or you could auto-party for them, but again, if you're just a random person and you're doing crossplay, how do you even text them? How do you even talk to them? If they're not on the same platform, how do you send them a message? How do you even know how to even find these people? You can't. There needs to be voice communication. There needs to be team chat. There needs to be a way to text people who are your friends or not your friends or whatever. Right? There needs to be that, because without it, you literally have no way to do anything outside of just be a solo player unless you have somebody that you already know or you're on Discord. That's it. So that's the first thing that they have to change. Because until that happens, you're never going to have people like be able to compete with the highest level of players who just have friends, and they have this little circle built around them, right? And they're just getting better because they're playing with each other and they're learning stuff together, and that creates a meta in its own, right? Anyone who's not in that circle, this is what happened with Naraka. Luckily for me, I was actually a part of that because I was a content creator for him, but also I knew a lot of people from that game. So I was lucky to be in that circle, and we developed the meta, and we made that game what it was. So that was cool, but honestly, that's not a good, healthy thing for your game. So I don't want that to be with this game, because what's going to happen is exactly what's happened with Naraka. It's just a noob fest. No one really plays in it either. So this game has to get the socials correct. After the socials, you have to get the servers, because before you can even work on the lab, because the lab will probably take a little bit of time. It doesn't even have to be extremely consistent. Like, I'm not asking for perfection in the lab. You can work on it over time. Just you need to give us the ability to record AIs, or at least get them to be able to do aerial moves over and over again, so you can lab against those moves. Because pro players have a mindset where I need to be able to beat every character no matter what they throw at me. I have that mindset to where I will literally spend 10 hours if I have to labbing every single character in this game if I could get them to do the moves that I feel like I struggle against. I'm the person who does that. There's no way for me to do that except hop online or go against a bot and then hope and pray that they do it. That's really boring. That there's no way to be consistently better. That you cannot do consistent work by doing crap like that. I don't have any friends who play the characters that I struggle against, so, and then all of the friends that I did have are leaving the game because the game's bad and because of the servers. So that's not an accurate thing. I need the bots to be able to do it, so that way I can just do it and do it myself, and then I can get into a higher level of play, maybe impress some people, and then they're like, oh, I need to hit this guy up, then we'll do it. I'm always gonna be like, I need to get myself right before I even try to get help from somebody else. That's just how I am. It's impossible to do that in this game. Not impossible, but it's just really tedious and boring and inconsistent. I don't like inconsistency. So this game has a very big problem whenever it comes to that as well. So servers, I've got to get better, because that's the reason why I don't want to play online, because the only other way for you to get better is to hop online and then just work on it and try to look out for those scenarios and then try to get a time in and try to remember that time and try to build it like that and then play a bunch of hours, right? But when the servers are lagging and you're getting skip frame here and there, you can't even work on it that. So even that becomes inconsistent. So if you're lagging, you're getting no work done, no practice, no, you're not getting better at the game. And that's already a really bad way to get better at the game anyway, because you can build a lot of bad tendencies because you're trying to get better. You can build a lot of bad habits by doing stuff like that. So not a good way to practice either. So I wouldn't recommend that. But the servers just help people feel better about the game. It allows for natural reaction, natural skill to kind of actually show a little bit more, and natural like characters actually feel a little bit more in line because now you're actually feeling the character and not the lag. You're not fighting the real boss, which is lag, but you're actually fighting the character. So, Iron Giant with lag, one of the most OP characters in the game. Iron Giant without lag, trash. Iron Giant online, character's not all that. But he's still a good character. So, those are the three things. Socials need to get better to where you can communicate with people. The servers have got to get better. But for me, the number one thing is the lab. You have to get this lab correct. If you guys do not know how to even begin on that, somebody please, a dev, contact me, my email, whatever. Send a comment, whatever. I will personally help you guys, and I will play test this thing and come up with everything that you could possibly think to use. Because the biggest thing that holds this game back is the lab, not the servers, not the balancing, not characters, not all that. I don't care what people are like. Oh, we need content. We need. You have the player base that is just looking for that, but they come and then they go. You get your money, then you get out. That's okay. But the players who are consistently going to play your game, those are the ones that are your player base. You have to take care of those players. People are leaving. The consistent players are leaving. Why? Because this game is not getting better. So I'm gonna end this video with this because it's already getting too long. You cannot base a game off of this analogy. So here's the analogy. I'm pretty sure you've heard it. It goes, you can give someone a fish and feed them for a day. You can teach them how to fish, and you feed them for life. What does that mean? Let's apply that to this game or to any game. You can give someone a fish, give a character a buff, give a character a nerf, because the players can't do it themselves, right? So you give them a fish, you feed them for a day. Ah, oh man, that character finally got nerfed, bro. Guess what? That character can still be good. For example, Superman. For example, Velma. For example, Bugs Bunny. You giving people fishes, right? Guess what? They're still going to need to eat another day. What does eat mean? Win. They're going to want to win. They're going to want to beat these characters. They're going to want to win in general, right? So they're going to need to eat, right? You can give them a fish to help them do that, but guess what? That's only going to be for one day. That character still has other things in their kit. That's, again, this is a new game. There's so much in a character's kit that's not being explored. You still can lose. And the nerfs that you guys are giving or the buffs, they're really small. It's not really making that huge of a difference in the grand scheme of things. So you give them a fish for a day. They're still going to be hungry, right? You got to feed them for life. How do you do that? Teach them how to fish. How do you teach someone how to win? The lab. Make it to where the lab can help players. Put a better tutorial out there. After you after you improve the lab, put a tutorial for the lab so that way you can teach them how to even use the lab. So that way they can work against a mix-up. Literally, I will personally help you guys do this because I've done this also for Honor. I literally have done this for the few For Honor devs because I was a part of that community of pro players. And we help them out with the lab so that way they can actually get that lab consistent. Because until the lab got improved on For Honor, that game was trash, and so many players were complaining. The only way we stopped the complaining in that game was by improving the practice mode, the training ground. So I will do that for this game with you guys as well. I just need for you guys to teach people how to fish. I'm tired of getting all these characters buffed and nerfed, and you learn how to counter, you learn a timing for it, and then it completely gets changed by the next patch. You learn a character, they get nerfed to where you can't use them anymore, or they get buffed again, and now they're stronger than they was before they got even nerfed in the first place. It's like, what are we doing? This is not healthy. This is not good. This is not consistent. This is not good for pro play. This is making LTC look like a joke because it looked like a joke. Like, anyways, we need to have a better lab so that way there's consistency. So that way you teach people how to fish and don't just give them a fish, because now you don't have to give them a fish, because you were like, I taught you how to fish. Go out there and work for it. Go out there and have a pro mindset. Go and get that fish. Don't ask me to do it for you anymore. I'm a person where, like, if there's a pat for me to get my own food, I'm gonna get it. 'Cause I don't want to have to ask somebody for a fish. I want to do it. But in this game, that path is so long and so tedious. And so, it's like, bro, what? It's not even possible, right? So that's what I have to say about this game. That's my current state of play. It's a fun game. Every character is viable. Every character in this game is A plus or higher. Every single character you can play. And that to me is good enough for balancing. You guys do not need to worry about balancing. I get you want to release characters because you want to keep the game exciting. Whatever. Cool. I get that. Your biggest focus should be socials, getting team comps. If ranked is released without socials being better, without the service being better, you will make people quit this game, I guarantee you. Because if they cannot communicate with a teammate, whoo, that's gonna be tragic. If they cannot have a good service, that's gonna be tragic. A lot of people are talking about like, oh, this game needs rank soon. No, you cannot release rank because then you're getting egos and pride and humility incorporated into all of this junk that is already with the community that is a bunch of crying, whiny babies. When you add all of that into this, a lot of players are going to get humbled and a lot of players are going to quit because whenever they feel like they belong in a way and they get humbled, either they're going to fight back and be like, all right, now I got to get better, right? And there's no way for them to do so. And let's say they worked on something and then it really didn't do anything because it's like, kind of like pointless training. They hop online, they still get dusted by the same junk. They're going to quit now because their rank is on the line, right? More people are going to quit your game if you add rank, and this game is not consistent. Do not add rank because that's exactly what happened with For Honor. It took them years before they even got a good healthy player base again because they put in ranked and the game was not ready for that, and then players didn't like what their rank was and they hopped out of the game because they felt like they were better and they actually were better. So do not add rank right now because it's gonna destroy your game. Focus on the things that we talked about and let it ride. So I know this video is a lot longer than I want it to be, but it is what it is. You guys know I talk, but hopefully you guys enjoyed it. This game, it's a fun game. Every character is viable, but there are three glaring issues with this game: servers, the lab, and socials. They fix socials, servers, lab. This game will be so much better. If you need help, devs, I got you. Player first games. Talk to a player. I got you guys. I love this game. I literally put so much time and money into this game. I care about this game. I will help you guys personally make this game better if you even care to use me or whatever. And if you don't, that's cool. I don't really care. I don't even know if a dev develops watches. I'm just saying the opportunity is there because I know what I'm talking about. I know what healthy play looks like. If you don't believe, that's up to you. Whatever. This game has those three problems. If you fix those three, automatically gonna be better for the healthy players, the good players. I don't care what a crybaby has to say, who's complaining. Crybabies are gonna complain in every game. That's just the way that it is. They leave whatever. They'll hop back in whenever a new character gets released because they work off nostalgia, they work off a hype, whatever. You got these hype train bees. Get your money from them and then let them go. But for your pro players, your consistent players, the players who are high level, the high level players who are struggling right now, like the Miramax, the Rose Jays, the Nakats, the all these players who are actually good players who really cannot even touch pro level play just because these three things are really kind of holding it back for them. Really, it's just the servers and the lab. Because I really don't think that balancing is that big of a deal. Right now, there's so much ways to outplay. It's just it's really hard to work on those. So, but that's just me personally. Some pros not may not some high level players may not agree with that, but that's them. That's their opinion. Either way it goes, you decide what gets patched and updated. Stop letting players dictate too much. You have too many propaganda patches coming out. But yeah, that's everything I have to say. It's JChaos. Deuces.